Yo guys, welcome back to the channel, welcome back to the Alex World. Hope you guys are doing great, hope you guys are taking good care of yourselves. Hope you guys have a wonderful week. Now today's reaction video is another G-Eazy. This was suggested by one of my fans, so shout out to you. You made it onto the video. This song is called Everything Will Be Okay. They suggested it, they wanted me to check it out. So here I am doing the favor. I'm excited to listen to this. They said it's really good, it's really deep. Compare like the one I listened to before with the song called Time from his album These Things Happen Too. So probably is going to be another emotional one, a really long one as well, which I love. Anyways, enough of me talking. Please leave a like, subscribe to the channel, and the notification bell. I appreciate y'all. You guys are amazing fans. You're the best community in the world I could ever ask for. Best family as well. I love you guys. Let's jump into the video. Let's listen to this track. No! Already, like, not even 5 seconds in. That intro sounds so clean. And this is by Kehlani, I think. So, okay. Oh, that's just so clean. This, that little part. The way they produce that is. It's that filters on top of it as well. Even if I don't stay, everything will be okay. Do you know how hard of a line that is to put straight at the very beginning? Even if I don't stay, insinuated, that can insinuate so many things. Like, you know, if the person walks out of your life, if the person passes away, you lose connection to them. These things mean, like, that one single line can mean so many different things. And it's so powerful. It has an effect. And especially with that intro, with that sound, a really melodic sound, with that, like, filter on top of it. And then you have this line. Bro, that was the cleanest transition. Oh, that voice. Everything will be okay. Everything will be okay. I hope. Contemplating just who I could have turned out to be. If I'd have stayed on my heart, what would amount to me? If I looked and ain't found what I found in me, I mean inside would they love me, never look down. So I'm guessing this part, he's talking about himself, like he's talking his perspective. It says, contemplating just who I could have turned out to be. If I had stayed and weren't heard, what would amount to me? Specifically, like if I didn't, like if you did do the things he's done today, would he be still in the same position as he is now? And like, if he wasn't heard, what, like his name, then would he be in the same place where he is, like, high artist in the music industry? If I looked and ain't found what I found in me, I mean inside, would they love me, never look down on me? Yeah. They say, you know, if you loved her, well, then you would have stayed. You could have made a perfect pair that people wouldn't trade. Trade for nothing I did, though I had to chase it. Face it, I wasn't born to live a life basic. I had to chase it, face it. I wasn't born to live a life basic. You know what's crazy though? Is that you do, if you want to get to the place you go, you want to be in, there are sacrifices you have to make, and it's insane. Because, like, you know, everyone dreams to go where they want to be. Like, they dream to have this, like, dream job, dream life they want. But they never put the work, they never put, like, you know, the sacrifices that need to be made. And it sucks because you do have to make sacrifices on the way in order to get to that place. Like, you gotta sacrifice your work. You gotta sacrifice your sleep. You gotta sacrifice, like, you know, free time. If you wanna be rich, if you wanna get to the point where in your life where you're a very happy, stable life, where you're like a very high rank, you gotta work hard effortlessly. You gotta keep training. You gotta keep doing these things over and over again until you get to the point where you're happy. And it's true though. And you still can balance out what other things, like outgoing stuff. But you have to work so hard to get to that place, like, over the whole time of your life. Or even a short amount of time in your life. You just gotta work hard, because that's the truth in life. Like, if you don't work hard, you won't get the results you want. They say you turned your back on us just to go on be an artist. What's a promise anyway when someone breaks it? I bet he finally gets a shot and then he wastes it. I bet he don't come back for us when he makes it. And if he do it... So I'm guessing this point of view right now is like, I bet he finally gets a shot and then he wasted. I bet he don't come back for us when he makes it. It's basically talking about, like, you know, the people around him, maybe family, maybe like friends, or like, you know, just people he knew around him were close to him. They say, like, you know, he's gonna forget us when he reaches his fame, or they were like, you know, trying to down him, like whatever.
It'd be too late, you gotta face it. Cause by then it's someone new you've been replaced with. Old friends I grew up with, the girl I fell in love with, love or hate me to
be. Whoa, that line just hit me right now. Cause by then the song you knew you'd been replaced with. That is true. You, the friends group you think you're friends with, you know, the people you were tight with when you're trying to chase their dreams, they will change up. They will turn around and they'll try to find someone else new. And when you come back, they'll be like, oh, you forgot about us. You never contact all this stuff. You know, those are the people who are trying to drag you down in life. And it's sometimes some of them will stick with you. You know, you don't always have to talk to them every day. Like, you know, there's some friendships where you talk to them for like whatever you want. You disconnect for a little bit, and then like 4 months later, you talk again, and you guys like it happened, like it never happened before. You know how you judge it. This hook is too good.
If you don't step in no mud, well then it won't last. Yeah. The years pass, it's crazy how they go fast. Ask myself questions you have, but that you won't ask. Mm. Like you don't even come home enough. Where were you when she was in the hospital, huh? It was only us, and that's deep, and yeah, I know it cuts. But if that gets you, then you're weak.
Where were you when she was in hospital, huh? It was only us, and that's deep, and yeah, I know it cuts. But if that gets you, then you're weak, because we're here, and it ain't broken us. Damn. That must have been hard for him, like, you know, like, his family members calling him, saying, like, you know, where were you when, like, this person was in the hospital, you know? That's kind of tough, because he was striving for his goal, and, like, the sacrifices he made is, like, his family and all that. No, I think I'm right. Like, I think I'm saying that. If I think I'm wrong, just correct me. But that's deep.
Because we were here and it ain't broken us. Still as close and stay by our side when no one was. Like when she lost a job and everything, I broke we was. When she was sick and she needed some taking care of. A 15-year-old shouldered the weight. And when he was scared of the worst, I know that you stay strong. I don't say this enough, but you made me just as proud as you made mom. Yeah, you got some anger, but I don't blame you at all. I know I don't call. But you're my brother.
That hit me in the chest, bro. Like, I know we don't go, but I never told you this. I love you. You're my brother. Wow. Everything will be okay. Everything will be okay. Everything will be okay.
Yeah. In that first grade class, they came and got me. Your mom's outside, say goodbye now to everybody. You all's waiting with all of her things, at least what she could pack. In the time my dad's at work and before he came back. Way too young to comprehend what was happening. Are we going to grandma's? When are we coming back again? Little did I know that we were leaving him by himself. And 10 years have passed before mom sees anybody else. Just us. In middle school, I ain't understand who Melissa was and why she wasn't another man. Biased and confused, they try to explain, but nobody can. Wanted what I thought was normal.
So they divorced his mom divorced the husband, and you know, the person who she was with, like when he, I think this was like maybe when he was younger, and he didn't understand what was going on. Melissa was another woman, and he didn't know that his mother loved another woman, and he couldn't comprehend that, you know, why he wasn't a man, I guess. But wow, such as life. This is deep. Even this is deep. It took time
for me to accept it. No longer dad now, but a woman with whom she slept with. Or for the years when a secret was how she kept it. I ain't get it. Admittedly, I was skeptic. I came around. Happiness, I see what you may have found. And that's what's most important. I don't want to see you breaking down. I want to see you smile. I don't want to see you make a frown. If she loves you, then that's all anybody needs. Maybe now. My own five things have gotten worse. Moved to the basement. Deep depression's a rotten curse. Hiding in a dark space. Her mind and her body hurt. Becoming more reclusive, and the pill should have been alerts. So the worse it got, I became more and more afraid. Until one night I went into that room on the floor she laid. I shook her, she was blue, her skin was cold, and she wasn't breathing.
Whoa, I got goosebumps here. So the girl that her mom was with was like on drugs or something, and like, you know, he was finally happy that his mom found happiness, and that's what he wanted. Oh, wait, is this her mom? Or is this, like, the brother or what? I think, am I wrong?
Scream, Melissa, wake up, couldn't fathom that she was leaving. Mom and bro is running down, I scream, somebody help. Chop up in her chest, CPR, but it didn't help. Toughest pill to swallow, but we lost, this forced reflection. While in her life, you made her happy, thank you for the blessing.
I got goosebumps, bro. I don't want to cry. Oh, man, they're really doing the instrumental right now? Shit. That's deep. So that Melissa girl made their mom happy. And she was suffering from, like, depression and all these things and taking pills. And she wanted to, like, escape life. And she succeeded in that. But you can see that if you ever go through the process or the thought of that, you know you're gonna hurt so many people in your life. Like, especially in this song, you can hear that, you know, G-Eazy, the mom, his brother were all hurt so much by that. And it's just like, that's a thing you need to know. Like, if you ever have those thoughts, you know, there are people out there in the world, like, who care for you. And, like, even if someone else found you, it would hurt them because they realize that a parent has lost their child or anything like that. It's a pain that is uncomprehendable. Like, I couldn't even fathom if I had a child and they resort to, like, hurting themselves or, like, even offing themselves. I would hurt so much, like, because you couldn't be there to help them. And it's, like, also from the perspective of, like, them being children, like, they love that person so much. Like, it took them a while to accept it, but they knew that that she made their mother happy, and now she suddenly left, and it, like, hurts them. Like, wow. Damn, dude! Oh! Oh my god. This hurts, that hurts. And they're doing this instrumental, man. That was Everything Will Be Okay by G-Eazy and Kehlani. Wow, that was deep. That was something else. That was beautiful, yet so powerful. It was, that just hit me so hard. I got me goosebumps. I actually love this song. It's beautiful, well-crafted, well-produced. I really appreciate the suggestion you guys made for that song. I love you all. I'll catch you in the next one. Please leave a like, subscribe to the channel, and notification bell. I'll catch you in the next one. Peace out. Take care. Love you all.